It's the Tribar Penrose Triangle Origami Style. Check the video description for more info. And now I'm going to teach you how to make it. Here goes. All right, so for this model, you need 4 squares of paper. You could use printer paper cut square, but one of them you're going to transform into a 2x1 rectangle and 2 little squares. So these 2 will be our connector pieces, and this one will be the abracadabra gimmick that makes the whole illusion possible. So let's do that right now. All right, begin white side up and fold in half. Make this crease super, super sharp. And unfold, turn over, and we're going to tear it right at the top here. Make a little tear, and now place it on the table with the ridge up and just separate your hands, and the tear should go all the way down. And this is going to be the magic gimmick. We'll do that last. And now we're going to make the 2 connector pieces out of this sheet. So white side up, fold in half, and unfold, turn over, make the tear, and spread. Okay, so we got our 2 sheets for the connector pieces. Let's do that first. So white side up, fold in half, unfold, and fold to the crease, and repeat. Unfold and repeat in this direction. Unfold. Okay. Now fold in half, but we're just going to make a crease right on this unit. So crease from there to there, and unfold. And now we're going to make one on this side. So fold in half and just crease there. So it's like that. And now fold this edge to this crease, and we're just folding on the first one like that, and repeat on this side. All right, so we've creased it like this. Now fold on this crease and fold the flap behind like that. And now fold down like this, so it takes on this shape. And now we're going to fold on these 2 creases. So push it together and make that flap go to the right. And this is the completed connector piece. So one connector piece is done. Rewind the video so you have 2 connector pieces. All right, so you have 2 connector pieces, and they're kind of flimsy, but they'll be more rigid when we use them to connect the bars. So let's make a bar. Important, in order for the illusion to work, you have to use the same color sheet for this bar as you did for the 2x1 rectangle gimmick. So begin white side up and fold in half. Unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. Unfold and fold to the last crease. Unfold and fold to the first crease. Rotate and fold to the first crease. Unfold and fold to this edge. And unfold, and now fold this flap up, rotate, and fold to the second crease. And fold like this. And unfold this flap and fold this flap. Rotate and fold up like this, and fold up like this, and unfold, unfold, and fold. Now hold it like this so that these flaps are on the right, and we're going to fold this edge to the crease, but just make a pinch on the first unit right there, and fold this edge to here, just folding on the first unit there, and now fold up like this, just fold on this unit and unfold. All right, so we have it like this. Now unfold these flaps and fold in half. And now you're going to tuck this flap in behind this flap. So it just curls in like that. And repeat on this side. So it's like that. Now we're going to go under this flap, so in here, and open it. If you made all the folds correct, it should just easily open up like that. But that's what it should look like. And you can flatten it like this. And find your creases. So right there, there, and there, and just practice folding that in like that, and carefully unfold it. All right, so the first bar is done, and I've drawn on the creases for clarity. So we have diagonal, straight, diagonal. Now grab your first connector unit, and the straight should be on top, and the connector unit should be oriented like this. And now we're going to put the connector piece inside the bar like this, so that it slides all the way in like that. And now we're going to push this in like we did before, but first unfold this so it's like this, and now carefully push it in like this, and now push this part in. It helps if you first close that, and now it should go in easily. And try to fold right on the creases. So it's like that. And our first connection is done. Now time to make another bar. So here goes. Same thing. Divide into 8. Thank you. Okay. So fold to the second crease. And fold like this. And unfold this flap and fold this flap. And now rotate and fold like this and like this. And unfold the flaps and fold this back up. All right, before we had the flaps on the right, now we're gonna have them on the left. And same thing, fold from here to here. So fold like this, one unit, and unfold and fold one unit here, and attach them by folding up like this, like that. All right, now unfold these flaps and fold this flap over. And here we go. Take this flap and insert it into the pocket. And repeat. And open it and flatten. Okay, so here are the creases. All right, so orient this so that it is down like that. And now this piece, make sure that we have diagonal straight on top and diagonal. So it's like this, and insert the connector into the bar, and it just slides in all the way, like that. And fold this in. And carefully pull it out. And grab your connector piece. Okay, so it's like this. The connector piece goes in here, like this, all the way in. And here we go again. So unfold here and push this in. Like that, and now fold this and push the rest of it in. Like that. And now, time to make our third bar. Same thing. And I am going to fast forward this one. Okay, and on this one, we don't need to make extra folds. So unfold these flaps and insert the flaps into the pockets. And complete the bar like we did on the other two. But on this one, we don't need to push in the end and pull it back out. Alright, insert this one in so that it's like this. This diagonal edge is pointing that direction. So it's like that. Okay, so this is what we have so far. Now it's time to make the gimmick. So, the 2x1 rectangle. Alright, just fold like this. Fold here. And fold on that edge. And unfold and unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. And fold in half. So here's the crease. Fold it like this. And unfold, and now rotate, and we're going to insert this into the slot right there. Make sure that the two edges are like that, and into the slot, like that, and now just flatten this end like that, and fold this flap over. And now we're going to turn over and fold the diagonal. So these two edges come together, but we're just folding to the crease. So, like that. And turn back over. And now pinch along this edge. Crease, like that. Okay, so this is what it should look like. We just made that diagonal crease, and we made this crease. Now, unfold this flap and open the bar like this. And now we're going to tuck inside like this. So it goes like this, and this gets tucked inside. So it's like this. And now just tuck this flap in about like that. We're using this edge to lodge the flap in so that it doesn't open like that. So just press it up against the gimmick like that. And now what happened? Oh, this came out. Okay, this goes back in. Like this. Okay, alright, so this is what it looks like so far, and the idea is that when we get it just right, this edge will align with this edge. But first, I'm going to try to get a better camera position. Okay, that's just about perfect. So now we just need to fold these corners behind just the right amount. So let's start about this much. Don't fold very sharply because we're going to adjust this fold. But of course we need to hide these. So fold this one inside. And actually fold both of them inside. and you want to try to get this edge to align with this edge. So it's the exact same length, and you might have to zoom further out or zoom further in order to get those edges to connect. In order to get these edges to line up perfectly, you'll probably have to tweak the shape of the rear bar. And make sure to push the bars together cleanly. And tweak the position of the gimmick flap in order to get it to line up perfectly. Like that. Now, if you're trying to capture the optical illusion with your eyes, not a camera, then you really need to close one eye so that you have just one focal point. So there you have it. Hope you guys were able to make this successfully and enjoy showing it to your friends. And if you weren't able to make it, I hope that you at least enjoyed looking at this illusion. And see you guys later. Bye-bye.